Look at these videos. In these videos, we used a special transition technique. This transition is very smooth, and the first image and the last image of the transition are completely unrelated. How is such a cool transition achieved? Next, let us introduce the relevant technology. I have also built a workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub. In the field of ComfyUI, Running Hub is a great online working platform. This is because whenever new models and new technologies appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in the description area of my video, which will grant you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you will receive 100 credits daily just by logging into Running Hub. This way, you can try out your own workflow. Structurally, this workflow is a standard Wan 2.2 firsty last frame workflow. Therefore, we need to prepare two images, take a look, a start frame and an end frame. Then we scale them according to our defined resolution. Next is the model loading part. This is a very important part for obtaining the entire transition animation effect. In fact, we introduced this technique in a previous video. We are simply moving it from image to video generation to first to last frame video generation. Let's take a quick look. These are the high noise and low noise models for Wan 2.2. Here, we use the light X to V Lora provided by Kijai. You can download this Lora using this address. We are also using this Lora for the low noise model to give it higher motion. Please note that I set the weights relatively high. One is 5.0 and the other is 2.0. Then we loaded a Pusa Lora separately. We have previously discussed the Pusa technique. It can give the video more motion. You can download the Pusa Lora used in the Wan 2.2 model via this address. There are high noise and low noise versions. The weight values given here are 1.5 for the top, high noise and 1.3 for the bottom low noise. This is our encoder. This is our VAE. To achieve more motion, I still used QWNVL and applied my image to video prompt engineering. This allows for the design of one action per SE cond, which makes the overall motion effect more prominent. The most important part here is the Wan first last frame to video node. We need to connect the positive and negative conditions generated by our prompt, the VAE, the output of the first and last frames after passing through the visual encoder, and the original first and last frame images, all connected to this node. This generates our new positive condition, negative condition, and latent. Further down, this is standard Wan 2.2 sampling. I am using 6 steps of sampling, the LCM sampler and the simple scheduler. You can upload any 2 images and you will get a great animation effect. This kind of transition is not achieved by simple deformation or crude effects like fade in or fade out. The character still exhibits motion and the character transition process is relatively smooth. It won't feel abrupt. Regarding the application of this, you need to be flexible. This is the workflow I showed you before. To achieve an extreme motion effect, I used 4 strategies here. The first is the high weight given to light X to V. This is 5.0 and 2.0. Similarly, the weight given to Pusa is also high, 1.5 and 1.4. We also used a relatively high motion prompt here. Furthermore, we used Painter I2V to reduce slow motion. That is why the effect you see is very superb. But note that this design is an extreme state. I have almost maximized the motion. In this situation, the effect looks good. However, in some scenarios, it may not work so well. For example, look at this. This workflow is exactly the same as before, except that I changed the image to a distant view. Let's look at the generated effect. You might already notice that the speed is very fast. Although it has a very good motion effect, and the overall performance is also good, you will find that in this situation, it is ultimately different from the videos we usually see. Even if you adjust the frame rate to 16 frames, the speed is still relatively fast. Therefore, using such a parameter design means your application is a bit overdone. Methods to reduce motion. First, we can slightly lower the parameter for light X to V. Another strategy is to replace Painter I2V with the traditional Wan image to video. Let's look at the result after our adjustment here. Our reference images have not changed at all. Now I've changed the light X to V for the Haijian noise model from 5.0 to 4.0. Below, I am using 2.0 Pusa weights are 1.5 and 1.4 with no change. Then, we replaced Painter I2V with the standard Wan image to video. Let's look at the generated effect again. Take a look, although the speed is still a bit fast. Overall, it already conforms to our basic perception of a normal video. You can adjust this to 16 frames, and it will become a relatively normal state. Therefore, what everyone learns are always methods for solving problems, not just a specific workflow. Let's go back to the video. The parameters I am currently giving are 5 and 2, which are relatively high. If you feel the motion is a bit excessive, you can reduce this value. For example, let's adjust it to 3. Let's run it again. The sampling is complete. You will find that this transition effect is lost. Let's change it to 4 and run it again. Okay, take a look. When we adjust it to 4, the feeling is a bit better than before, but the transition is not very obvious. Now, let's adjust it back to 5 and run it again. Look, this is the 5 setting. The 5 setting is much better. The overall change is more drastic. Regarding the lower parameter, 2.0, we suggest that you do not exceed 3 because the screen might collapse. There is another trick. If you feel the motion is insufficient, you can use user input in my prompt engineering to tell it what the person is doing. For example, I now add a user input stating that the beautiful woman is practicing Tai Chi. Essentially, I have constrained her action. Let's run it again. Feel it. The sampling is complete. Her movement looks more like practicing Tai Chi, with strong motion and relatively large amplitude. Once we explicitly tell the model what the character is doing, there are two benefits. The first is enhanced motion, which you have already seen. The second is that when you use multiple keyframes for first to last frame transitions, it will look more unified and harmonious. For instance, the example we showed everyone at the very beginning, note that the style of each image may not be the same, and the characters are also different. However, because I explicitly stated that the character is practicing Tai Chi, you will find that the movement performance and overall rhythm are similar. Therefore, when you are transitioning multiple images and connecting them together to make a video, I suggest you still use an explicit way to tell the model what the character is doing. We covered a lot of content in this video. Essentially, we summarized the problems that may arise when using high-weight settings for Light X to V and Pusa to increase motion, and how we should deal with these problems once they occur. That is all for today. Follow me to be someone who understands AI.